channel. If you're new, welcome. I'm Lorena, and today I am doing some DIY home decor. I've been wanting to do a couple of DIY projects that I've had the materials for and the items for a while now. I just haven't had the time to do it, but I'm officially a teacher on summer break. Yay, I'm so excited. But I feel like I have a little bit more time to do fun stuff like this. So I thought I would just share with you guys, hopefully give you some DIY ideas and home decor inspiration. And I hope that you enjoy. So I really want a new wreath for our front door. I DIY'd this one a long time ago and it's okay, but the flowers are just starting to look like worn and old and just kind of like it needs a little upgrade. So I got these from Hobby Lobby. I really liked them. They're beautiful flowers and then just a really big beautiful green leaves. So let's see what we do with this one. After removing the florals and the little hello sign, the wreath itself was in really good shape still, and I actually got it several years ago from Michaels, but I'm glad that it held up nicely so I can reuse it. So if you're looking to do a wreath yourselves, Michaels has a lot of affordable options to start with, and then I'm just taking the magnolia flowers and leaves off the stems, and then I'm just gonna use hot glue to glue them on, and I'm gonna do it at an angle, like at the bottom on a little corner, and just bunch them together there. Before I'm too invested, I should probably ask ya. I'm just placing them on the wreath first to see how I want to glue them, and then after I figured how I want to do it, then I go in with the hot glue. I really wanted a wreath that wasn't necessarily specific to any season, so something really neutral and beautiful. That's why I went with these magnolia flowers, and they're really pretty and big, and I really like the white, and I think they just stand out really well. It kinda makes me go crazy. But we should take it slow, work things out so you don't let me go. When I come real close, I don't wanna get hurt. And after the wreath, I'm also gonna DIY some decor beads. The style that I'm doing are called bone beads, and I really love how they turned out, really modern and beautiful, and they look really high end, but they were affordable to do. And then I'm also doing an aged stone look vase. I've done some in white, but this one is in black, and I'm using a different technique, and I really love how it turned out. And I just like that I was finally able to do all these projects and I had time for them, and I really like how everything turned out. And this is the material that I'm using for the next DIY project, which are the bone beads. And this is where I got the inspiration from. These are from McGee & Co. And as you can tell, they're $95, which I was not willing to spend, but I really, really liked them. They're just different than the regular decorative beads. I like that they're flat and they have just a different shape. And so I think that they look really beautiful. And so I got some air dry clay. I got it off Amazon, and I'll link it down below for you guys in case you want to try them. They were so easy to do, almost like therapeutic working with the clay and relaxing as well. So I'm just rolling 2-inch balls, and I did 50 of them, and the clay is supposed to dry within like a couple of days, but I was impatient, so I actually put them in the oven, which I'll show you all that process right now. But I just did the 50 balls, and then After that, without letting them dry, so right away I went in and formed them into little squares and rectangles. The key is to not have them be exactly the same, so there's no wrong way to do it. Just kind of flatten them out and make them into little squares. Uneven is probably best. And then after that, I just took a large threading needle and poked holes down the middle. I made sure to do it on both sides. That way it was big enough for the jute string that I used to string them. That way the jute string fits when going through each of them. And then I actually let them dry overnight. And they were pretty hard, but not completely. So putting them in the oven is what made them actually harden very well. I want you to show me what you feel. You're watching me like you want me, but you're still holding back, still holding back. Honestly, you're annoying me with the way that you keep playing. Show me. And like I said, I just use a jute string to string them. And then I just tied some little loops at the end on both ends. You can even do like some tassels if you wanted to, but I wanted to keep it really simple, so I just did loops to hold them in place. And they actually came out really cool. I really like them. I think that they look different, really pretty, high end, but they were really affordable to do, so I really, really like how it turned out. Show me your love like it is, like it is. And open my heart like you're fearless. Steal all the gold you can get, you can get. Show me your love, leave me breathless, breathless. And moving on to the vase, like I said, I really wanted to do a black aged stone look instead of the white, which I've done before. And this is the vase that I'm using. I think it's from IKEA from many years ago, and I just hadn't used it in like a long time, and I just had it and thought it would be perfect to use. And it already has kind of like a dark glass color, so I thought black would be perfect to do. So I am doing some A lot of texture, of course, is what you want with that aged stone look. So I'm adding some baking soda and then just giving it the first coat. And right away you can tell that it starts to get texture. That baking soda really helps. And then the more baking soda you add, the more like thick that your paint will be and the more texture it's gonna have. This is where I got the inspiration from. And this vase, as you can tell, is $156, which, again, not willing to spend when I can just make it myself. And it turned out, I think, even better than that one, in my opinion. But I went in with the first coat, let that dry, and then went in with a second coat, again adding some baking soda to really thicken it up and give it even more texture. And then after I did the second coat, I let that dry. I'll take you anywhere you want, as long as we're together, everything we'll do, you got me going on. And as you can see with that second coat, it already has a lot of texture, which you can even stop there. I think it still looks really pretty, but I wanted a specific look, so I kept going and adding more. I'm actually going to be using coffee grounds, so I just kept some of my Keurig's used cups and then just dumping the coffee grounds. I just ended up using two of them, and then I'm using some spackling to add even more texture, so I'm just spreading that throughout the vase with a just plastic knife, and then using my fingers just to spread it all over. And the hints of black, of course, are still gonna be there. And then I'm gonna go on top of that with more black paint using a sponge, but I did let the spackling dry before I did that.
When I look in your eyes, I don't know how, but it feels like I'm drunk on you. It's almost like you make me fly. And when I look at you smile, I don't know how, but it feels like I'm drunk on you. It feels like I'm drunk on you. It feels like I'm drunk on you.
And it already has a lot of texture because of the spackling, but using the dish sponge also really helps with that texture and that look that I was going for. And I just get the sponge from Dollar Tree, so super easy and affordable. And then going in with the coffee grounds, I'm just spreading around with my fingers, and then I also dip the sponge in the paint and in the coffee grounds and then go over it with that. And after I let that dry, I went in with some light brown paint and a bristle brush. And then after that, I really didn't like how the brown paint came out. Like, I did a little bit too much. I should have done less. So I went in just with a paper towel and just kind of dabbed that in and mixed it a little bit better. And then I went in with some black paint with the bristle brush as well, and then just went over it a little bit. But overall, I really like how it turned out. I'll show you right now, but it has so much texture and it's just really beautiful. Thanks so much for watching, friends. I had a lot of fun doing this DIY decor, and I hope that you enjoyed it, got some ideas, or were inspired to try doing some DIY decor yourselves. And I will see you on my next one. Bye. But every time you thought that we did all right.